perhaps we should take a moment. It's all right, I just need to go back. I want to go back. Let me go back. Back then, the men would look and smile at me like boys applying for a summer job. But no, I never would respond. The vacancy was taken. Back home, my love would whisper in my ear those words that shut a foreign troubled soul. That voice like sunshine when you're cold, like water when you're thirsty. But then one morning he was gone. A day went by and he was gone. A month went by and I would stand there at the window, holding the baby, shaking with fear. Then one day I heard it, as real as the sun, that voice in my ear. That's when I realized it. He was invisible, like a magic trick, like a miracle. I don't know how he did it. He was gone, but he still was there. Where they could keep an eye on me. Despite the bars across the window, my room was pretty sunny. Those days were mumbles in a sleeping ear. The hallways always smelled like chicken soup. Most of the doctors were polite. The nuns were nice and nanny. You eat your lunch, a year is gone. Go to bed 10 years are gone. Then you wake up and wonder, where is it hiding? Where did it go? I don't understand. The life I had wanted, the life I was promised, the life I had planned. Then I realized it was invisible. That entire life was invisible because somebody misplaced it, so it had to be somewhere. Just out of reach, just out of sight, there's a couple dancing in candlelight. No gravity, we're spinning in the air.
I think we've had enough. Councillor Signora, your petition is denied.
Are good that it's only me. I'm invisible.